Are you struggling with protocols and delegates in iOS? Keep on watching to learn how you can build out this application really, really fast and easy. Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and if you want to build out this application, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, open up Xcode, and let's just jump right into it. So let's take a look at our example project that I have built over here. Let's just build and run and see what we are going to achieve today with the help of protocols, of course. So while you are waiting for this to build, go ahead and check out the link in the description to get the resources for this tutorial. So here is our Apple logo with some text and info. And this is basically a profile so you can get a hands-on experience with protocols. Okay, let's take a look at our settings, because in the settings we are going to change some things and that will be reflected in the profile view controller. And let's see, let's select our Swift logo here and some red, and there's some name, let's say Swift and language. There we go, and hit the check mark, and there we go. Everything has been changed, and all of this with the magic of protocols. Okay, let's just start building out this app from scratch. So I will create a new Xcode project here, and it will be a single view application. So file, new, let me just resize this a little bit so we can see it better. So a single view application, let's click on next here, and I will name it protocol delegate. Okay. And make sure that the user interface is storyboard, so no Swift UI. There aren't any protocols or delegates in Swift UI. Those are stats and observables that we are going to use. And in this instance, protocol delegate is okay. Storyboard, let's click on next. And let's just drag and drop it anywhere in our computer. Let's click on next. And there we go. Let's just resize this so we can see this a lot better. Great. Now, what we want to do is take a look at the downloaded resources now. And inside here, we have some assets, a profile view controller, scene delegate. So let me just delete what we don't need here and just drag and drop what those will be. So let's just click on delete here. Move to trash, and let's just select all of these and drag and drop them right over here. Okay, make sure that we copy all of them accordingly. Okay, next up, I want to delete the main storyboard because I don't need that. I don't really like to work in storyboards, as you might already know. So let's delete that. One final thing is to, well, there are two things that we need to do here. First of all, let's just delete the main interface. So there we go. Let's leave that as empty. And under info, just select support application scene manifest, scene configuration, application session role, item zero, and delete basically the storyboard name. So for that to be shown, let's see this more. Okay, let's go back to our project. And now let's just take a brief look at it and how it looks like. Well, in the scene delegate, we are basically creating our profile view controller and we are showing it. In the settings view controller, we are just setting things up. Go ahead and take a look at this in depth. I don't want to waste much time here. Let's just build and run and take a look at it in the simulator. And yeah, we have a profile model here and we have some assets, icons, white icons that we are using. So let's see here. If we go, let's select some other stuff, but nothing really will happen. Okay, the code is running, so now it's time to talk about delegates. So what we want to understand here is how delegates work. Think of a client or a worker and the boss. Now, the boss is always telling the worker what to do, and the worker is listening to its boss. That is kind of how protocol delegates work. Now, in our case, the settings view controller is the boss. We are setting things up, so we know that we really want to change the icon. So the boss is telling the other view controller, the worker, the profile view controller, okay, I want you to change this and this, the icon, the title, and the info. Okay, so think of it like this. The settings view controller is our boss, and the profile view controller is our worker, our listener for that delegate. So let's start off with the settings view controller, and to basically create our boss, that is a protocol. So let's just go ahead and create our protocol here. And I usually name it the class, so the settings view controller, and I append delegate to it. So delegate. Okay, now this is basically the boss. Now, what can the boss tell to our workers? And this is where our functions come in. So func, and let's say in our case, it's just pretty straightforward. Did change profile, and we are going to say, okay, we did change profile to this profile. So we are going to insert our profile here. So did change, and let's just use this underscore here, profile, and it will be of type profile. Okay, again, profile is a model that I have created and I'm using it here. So now that the boss is ready, we want to basically implement it on our settings view controller. And that is, again, pretty straightforward. Just create a delegate, so var delegate, and you could name it like settings view controller delegate. It doesn't really matter. In some cases, if you are adhering to a lot of protocols, then you might want to change this to a more specific delegate. The variable name. Okay, delegate, and that is settings view controller delegate. And this is an optional. We might use it, we might not, but we will use it, and we are going to use it when we actually tap on that check mark at the top right, and that is a UI bar bottom item that has a selector, and well, basically what should that do when we are tapping on it? And it's currently printing out the profile, and in the previous build you can see that we have an icon one. This is what we tapped on, and what I'm going to do here is call the delegate. So delegate dot did change profile, and I'm just going to add in our profile. Okay, now this means that whomever, well, the boss is giving this command, did change profile. Now, whomever is listening will perform this did change profile. So it will basically grab the profile that I'm feeding it in here. So let's listen for this protocol, and let's go to our profile view controller, because that is the worker that we are going to listen in. And you could add adhere to the protocol like so, like settings view controller delegate, and then you add the required functions. But as you can see, it already says that we need to add our protocol stubs, but that is kind of messy, and I like to just create some extensions on our view controller. So let's just scroll all the way down and create our extension here. Now let's just wait for the fix, and just tap on the error and just fix it. And Xcode automatically adds that protocol stub. Okay, did change profile. Now we can use our profile that we have fed in the settings view controller to our advantage. And what do we want to do? Well, we want to present it on this view controller. And neatly, we do have already a function here, apply profile. Now this adds the image view, the icon image, the name label, and the info label according to the profile that we feed into this apply function. And just a quick note here, because we want to have tint color, we have set the UI image to the rendering mode of always template. Okay, so this is pretty straightforward. Apply, and we are using our profile. Okay. Now, we did conform to the protocol delegate, but we are still not listening to it, okay? And that is pretty straightforward to do. When we do create our settings view controller, we want to set the delegate to this view controller. So when we did create our controller, it's here. We just grab our created controller, and that delegate should be our view controller, the profile view controller, and that is self. Okay, and that's it. That is how you can add the protocol delegate to your project. So let's just build and run. Again, we are kind of a master and worker. This is the worker, the profile. Currently, we have some default values. Go ahead and take a look at the code for the details. And now we go to the master, the boss, and we select, let's say, our Rebeloper logo and some nice color to it, and enter Rebeloper, and let's enter some info, dev. And when we do tap on this check mark, whomever is listening for this delegate, let's say, function, it will implement it. So yeah, the profile will listen to it, and there we go. We have implemented the protocol to our profile view controller, and that's how simple it is. I hope you really enjoyed this foundational video about protocols and delegates. Now, I want you to hit that notification bell, because in my next video, we are going to talk about Apple sign-in with Firebase. Really awesome stuff. While you wait for that, make sure to check out also these two videos as well. I talk a lot about Swift UI, iOS development in general. So make sure to like those two. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.